Welcome to the glass plate. Today I will show you how to calculate the drag force with the drag coefficient by an example. Okay. Imagine you have a sphere in a fluid. It doesn't matter what fluid, the fluid is flowing around the sphere. But first you have to know how the fluid is flowing around the sphere. You can do it by calculating Reynolds number. Reynolds number can you calculate with this formula. You have to multiply the density of the fluid with the diameter of the sphere with the velocity of the sphere in the fluid. And you have to divide this by the viscosity of the fluid. Now you can calculate Reynolds number and you can say something about the flow. You can have two situations with this flow. You can say, okay, you have situation one. That's when Reynolds number is below 1. This says about a flow that's a linear flow. That looks like this. So the fluid is flowing linear around the sphere. Now you can say, okay, we can use Stokes' law. And Stokes' law says that the drag coefficient is 24 divided by Reynolds number. And the second situation is when Reynolds number is above 1. Then you have a turbulence flow. So the flow isn't flowing linear, but it's making a lot of turbulence after the sphere. So there's no relationship anymore between the drag coefficient and Reynolds number. So you have to use a graph to determine the drag coefficient. Okay, so you now have step 2. You have a drag coefficient. With this drag coefficient you can calculate the drag force. You can do this by using this formula. You have to multiply the drag coefficient times the cross-sectional area times 1 over 2 times the density of the fluid, times the velocity of the sphere in the fluid, and it's the square velocity. So, this is the method to calculate the drag force with the drag coefficient. I hope you can solve all the exercises now. Good luck with that.